In part two of the A to Z video series, I taught you about finding out the health department requirements. If you looked up those codes and talked with someone, you now should know what features you must have on your cart and may have possibly heard some other stuff as well. We will be discussing the type of cart you need and what features it must have in another video. But for now, let's discuss the things you may have never heard before, and now you've got questions since talking to them. You may have also heard that you had to have a canopy or a full bug screen or something else that just doesn't sound right. Remember in the previous video, I referred you to an article called "If Their Lips Are Moving, They Are Lying." That will come in handy about right now, because oftentimes you can go to the health department or go look at the codes and things just don't jive or they don't sound right. They sound impossible. Like, you know, you could have a health inspector says you need a pink lacy bug screen around the cart with yellow daisies. I'm exaggerating a little bit, but there's some things that you will hear where you'll go, okay, but I need to see that. And that's the point of that. If their lips are moving, they're lying. Check that out. You may have heard the word commissary mentioned or saw it in the codes for your state. So what exactly is a commissary? Why do we need one? And how can I easily get one? A commissary is just a fancy French word for commercial kitchen. Your health department will probably require this for several reasons. Washing pans that are 5 times larger than your sink is impossible on a cart. Some health department codes will say that your sinks need to be at least big enough to submerge the largest pan. Well, this is why they require commissaries, because at a commissary, you'll have a 3-bay sink, and it will be able to do that. Even though the cart may have a 3-bay sink and a hand wash sink, they're small. They're perfect for doing utensils, perfect for doing your ladle or your spatulas or any of that type stuff, but it's not perfect for washing pans. That is what a commissary comes in. A commissary is a place for you to do all that extra work, that prepping your food, cutting onions, making chili, coleslaw, and all those things that need to be done in the safety of 4 walls and a roof. A commissary entails a 3-bay commercial sink, a hand wash sink, and whatever appliances you may need, a fridge, a freezer, a grill, a deep fryer, whatever you're doing. It gives you a place to keep frozen or cold your stock, along with a place to prepare, cook, and clean up after a day of slinging. Some people are allowed to make their own kitchen, an approved commissary, their own home kitchen. This doesn't go for most states, but some states do allow this. But most states require you to get a commercial kitchen, you know, the use of a commercial kitchen like at a restaurant or, any type of food service establishment that has a commercial licensed kitchen. Use theirs, or you borrow it or rent it. And some people just let you use it. Or you have to build one yourself. Now, building one yourself in some states can be very easy. Some states say as long as it has a separate entrance and it has a 3-bay sink, a hand wash sink, and a floor drain. That's all they care about. They don't care what equipment's in there, just as long as you have those items. Some states say that they have stricter codes around that. But I've seen people turn a mini storage unit into a commercial commissary. So there are ways to get this done. We're going to talk about that a little bit later. The potential for contamination is much greater on a cart. And so when a health department limits your ability to prepare foods on a cart, all they're doing is taking into account that it's safer in the commissary for you to make your chili and dice up tomatoes and all that stuff you've got to do. It's safer to do it in there than to do it on the cart, because the cart is not enclosed and it's open to contaminants. Now, some states allow you to do other foods besides hot dogs. Not many, but some states do. But they have this little caveat, this little rule. And it says, if you prepared it at the commissary and you individually wrapped it, single size portions in food safe containers, like let's say you were making soup at the commissary and you put it already in the approved containers, styrofoam containers or plastic containers, or you made hamburgers at the commissary and you're just going to reheat them on the cart, or you made chili or whatever you did, they're okay with that. Some states don't care. So a lot of vendors you hear, even on the radio show at Hot Dog Vendor Radio, they are serving chili. And you go, well, how can they serve chili? Well, it's because they're following that rule. They're following the rule that says, as long as you prepared it there and as long as it's in individual servings, we're okay with it. And so that may be something for you to look into to expand your menu options. And now you know what a commissary is and you shouldn't have any more questions there, but you probably have some questions on how to get one. You know, I talked about getting them from a restaurant or using a restaurant. I'm going to tell you some tips and tricks on how to get them and even some ways to maybe manipulate the system a little bit. So we'll be back with that in just a little bit.